This program was paid for by Water of Life Church. From Water of Life Ministries in Plano, Texas, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is speaking through his servants to the world. He that hath ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying today. Let us join Doyle Davidson and others of Water of Life, sowing the Word of God in spirit and in truth.
Hello, I'm Doyle Davidson, servant apostle of the Lord Jesus Christ, ministering locally to the body of Christ in Dallas and Fort Worth, Texas, sent by God to your house to declare to you the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:3-4, tell us what the gospel is. How that Jesus Christ died for our sins, according to Scripture, he was buried, he rose again, the third day, according to the Scripture. Spirit of the Lord's upon me. He's anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, sent me to heal the broken heart, preach deliverance to the captives, recovering sight to the blind, set at liberty them that are bruised. Word is nigh thee, even in your heart, in your mouth, is a word of faith, which I preach. You confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus. Believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto righteousness. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. There's a power of God unto salvation. Everyone who believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God, built from faith to faith, as it is written, just to live by his faith. I want to welcome everyone receiving this broadcast on live stream, Roku, Apple TV, YouTube, other devices. Thank God. Amen. Amen. They got it bad. Kathy Davidson, co-host, present with me. Good morning.
Good morning.
And how are you?
I'm doing well.
Good. Terry Brown, co-host, present with me. And good morning. How are you?
Good morning. I'm well.
Great. Amber Byers, Colorado. We have Kathy Currier. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good to talk to you again. Amen. Yes. I got amen. And we have Anthony Reese with us. Good morning.
Good morning.
Amen. We have Brian Bonner with us. Good morning.
Good morning.
Paul Peters. Good morning.
Good morning.
Is he cool?
He's cool.
And Eric is no, he's at work, right?
He's up in a tree, right?
Huh?
Yes, he's okay. Working.
Thank you. Thank God. Well, what do you say? We have the Mai Girls come in.
Amen.
Amen.
Rejoice for the steps of a righteous man.
Jesus Christ, the body of Christ, knows little or nothing about God. Little or nothing about God. Why? Because they've never been taught.
Amen.
Never been taught. And they can't take the Bible and read it and believe it. It's impossible. You see, I am a prophet and teacher and an apostle. And who taught me? God.
Amen.
God. All should be taught of God. And I learned, disappointing to me, that I couldn't love the world and God at the same time. No, I had to sanctify my house. I had to get the world out of my house. Yeah. Get the world out of my house. And when people would come to see me and they were full of the world, I'd have to overcome what they left in my house. Now, you may think I'm tough. No, I'm smart. Smart enough to read the Bible and know what it says. And it says that you cannot love God and the world. If you love the world, get this, if you love the world, you have not God in your heart.
Amen.
Are you there?
I have that verse if you'd like me to read it.
Well, I wouldn't mind.
It's 1 John 2, and it's verse 15. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
Love not the world, nor the things of the world. My friends, you could read Psalms all day and love the world the rest of the day, all night, and you're full of the world, and you have not the Father in you. Now, I've got a group of people that think you can read the Word a little while and everything's okay. No, you're going to have to read the Word day and night. It takes dedication to the Word, not read the Psalms for an hour and think you did something. You did nothing. You did zero. Did you know to read the Psalms aloud is prayer? Did you know the scripture says pray without ceasing? Can you do that? Can you read the Psalms for 2 hours and not love the world for the next two? You can't do it. You're going to have to lay it down, folks. Well, Doyle, I've just got certain things I've got to do. You sure do. Repent and believe the gospel. Take up your cross daily and follow Jesus.
Amen.
I can't help you. I cannot help you. You're above the world. I'll pray for you. I do pray all the time. I can do a thing for you. And when you won't give your life to the Word of God and walk in the Word and not be tied up with the love of the world. You see, Bob, my kids don't love us. They love the world. But they're my kids, and I got to love them. You know what love would be? Shape up. Shape up. And don't come back to my house until you have laid your life down and pick up the cross daily and follow Jesus. Could you treat your sweet little kids that way? Well, I can. And I have. Amen. Are we ready to praise the Lord?
Amen.
Have I said enough? Silence is golden. Let's go, folks.
You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should shout for the praises of Him. A royal priesthood.
Thank you. blessed Redeemer, living Word.
Blessed Redeemer, Redeemer. Jesus, Jesus, Lord.
Probably. I'm going to remind us of something that those of us that have been here for a long time, I learned back in the 80s from Doyle. I'm going to Matthew 12, verse 43. It says, when the unclean spirit has gone out of a man, he walketh through dry places seeking rest and findeth none. Then he saith, I will return unto my house from whence I came out. And when he is come, he findeth it empty, swept, and garnished. Then goeth he and taketh with himself seven other spirits more wicked than himself, and they enter in and dwell there, and the last state of that man is worse than the first. Even so shall it be unto this wicked generation. And I have a beautiful testimony of this, and I'm going to use his name. About a month ago, I was working with Darren Cordova, and he came into my office one Wednesday night. We were working on another issue. And when I walked in, I went over my desk and put my mic away, and I turned around, and Darren looked at me, and he said, Kathy, would you pray for me? He said, there is a spirit that has been hounding me ever since I was a little boy. And I said, well, certainly. And we just talked for a moment, and then I saw Darren's face. And I saw that the Holy Spirit was already ministering to him. And his face, he started kind of getting kind of contorted. And I knew what was going on. God was starting to deliver him of it right there in my office. Amen. And I did. I commanded that devil to come out of him. And it did. It shook him and it shook him and then it tore him. I mean, it was a great deliverance. Amen. And he got up. He was kind of bent over on the floor. And he got up and he said, wow, do I feel better? And you know what happened? I love this. I didn't find this out until the following Sunday. He walked out. He went back out to his truck to drive home. And he said, on the way home, that spirit came into the truck looking to get back into its house. Amen. And, you know, Darren hasn't been taught as much as we have. He wasn't here in the Water Life Christian Training School. But the Spirit of God, you know what he did? He took his arm and he started banging on his chair. He said, no, you won't. You will not come back in me. You will not come back into me ever again. Do you know what? It left. It left. You know what James 4 says? It says, resist the devil and he will flee from you. But you know what we do? God delivers us or heals us, and we go home and we start feeling the same symptoms or the same feelings, and we say, ah, it didn't work.
Amen. That's right.
We don't resist the devil. Yes, it did work.
Yes.
Don't leave the door open. And you know what Doyle's taught us from the very first, one of the very first times God delivered me, Doyle said afterwards to those of us that were being delivered, there were more than one. He said, now you go home and you read the Psalms and you read the New Testament and you read that word out loud and get that body, that house occupied.
Amen.
So that the devil won't come back.
Amen.
And that's where I'm going to leave it off.
Are we finished?
We're finished.
Well, let's do Holy Highway. What do you say? Browns. and ball peters. God has blessed my ministry with some great voices, and their faith is growing. And oh, what a revival. Amen. Mercy, grace, mercy, grace, mercy, grace be multiplied unto you through the knowledge of God and the Lord Jesus Christ. God bless. See you tonight. Amen.
We invite you to visit Water of Life Church at 1621 18th Street in Plano, Texas. Or for further information, call area code 972-578-8082. That's 972-578-8082. Or write Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. That's Doyle Davidson, Post Office Box 861327, Plano, Texas 75086. This program was paid for by Water of Life Church.